Hey guys, it's Kristen with another Chance Resale, and in today's video I'm going to be unboxing, or I should say unbagging, the mystery purse from Goodwill Blue Box. So first, I just want to say that it came, I don't want to like show anything, but it came really, really ripped. Like the whole bottom corner was ripped open. I did email them. I didn't really expect a reply, and I wasn't blaming them because I know it's not their fault. However, I wanted to maybe try to have them consider mailing the purses in boxes because this is their Goodwill Blue Box that they launch on Friday nights, and I've gotten the purse one before. It's $19.99 for one purse, but every time I've gotten it, I've gotten two purses, but it comes in this bag, and I understand it's like recyclable, reusable, decomposable, whatever it is, but mine's like torn to shreds. So I decided to email them and just ask if they would consider maybe switching to boxes. I put a picture in there. I explained that, you know, I'm a frequent buyer, blah, blah, blah. I was being really nice. And they actually wrote back within a day, and they said that they have had multiple people email them with the same issue, and since they have ordered boxes to ship their purses out in. So I am shocked and very happy. So after that extremely long intro, let's get into the opening of the Goodwill Blue Box mystery purse. So, since it's basically open already, let's just dive on in. Okay. All right. So, first, so they did send two again. I don't know why they only write one on the website, but whatever. So, this box is $19.99, and I guess they give two purses, but even though it only says one. So this is the first one. It's an older style Coach top flap buckle satchel, maybe. It's definitely been loved. There is like dirt everywhere. But as far as like the edges and the leather itself, it's actually really nice. So let's check the inside. It's actually really nice on the inside. So maybe this was just in somebody's like garage or something forever. 'Cause there's like marks like by the handles and stuff right here. But honestly, I can just wash it. I can use some OxyClean in the sink and hand wash it and air dry it. And honestly, it's good to go. So it has the hang tag. Even though this is an older style, I can probably still at least get $40 for it. So that's purse number one. That was good. And purse number two. Okay, it's another vintage Dooney. My first box bag. I had gotten a vintage Dooney as well. And it was this color, but with black like edging and stuff. And that's actually in my antique booth at the moment. This is just the brown, almost like a little messenger bag, top, whatever you want to call it, flap. Really nice on the inside. This one is in like really good shape. There's a pill in here. Let's see what it is. I can't even grab it. It says Protonics. I don't know what that is. Okay, so we're just gonna put that right back in there. bag for now. The strap has like barely any wear. There is wear on the little emblem ducky. But other than that, it's pretty sweet. So this one I can probably try to sell for like $80, 60 to 80. If anyone is interested in either of those, let me know, because it'll probably take me like a couple weeks to get that listed. At least 2 weeks, because I'm that far behind. Another chance resale one at gmail.com. And I wanted to show you guys what I do with vintage sweater clips. You know, they're usually, sometimes they are placed at the collar, like on the collar, the neckline. And some of them have like chains that go across, or they can be put like to hold a shirt closed. Well, I use them to hold my little kimonos closed. So they're little bees, and I picked these ones out because I think they're reminiscent of Gucci. And they are a pinback. So I thought, I got these on Etsy. Someone made these and I just thought they were so cute. But that's how I keep my kimonos closed that don't have like a tie. So I'm not like going like this all day at work trying to keep it closed. I can do what I need to do and it'll stay in place. So I just thought I'd show you my little tip. And also I wanted to make a little announcement. I was recently given, not really given, but an opportunity came up where I could become a consultant with Swarovski. They have like a sister brand called Touchstone, and they are known for like home parties, you know, like paparazzi, but it's Swarovski. And I actually have been buying their stuff for probably about 6 to 8 months now. Me and my other friend, and I was brought the opportunity to be a consultant. And this is just like an example of some of the stuff they have. These are the ice bracelets, which are my favorite. They come in, I think, like 60 different colors. And these are just stretch bracelets, and they're all like fabric friendly, so they don't snag your clothes or anything. So I wanted to let you guys know about that. There's no, like, it's not like a reselling thing. It's actual Swarovski, straight from, you know, the company itself. I can't do discounts, none of that. I signed up. I will have my own link where you can check out the catalog if you're interested, or just see what it's about, see what they have. And that will be in the description box below. I also have a Patreon, but I talk about that a lot. But if you're new here, I offer help for resellers who are either starting out or just need some help or want, sorry guys, I got a phone call. So yeah, just check out the links below. I won't bore you anymore with my plugs over here. So thanks for watching. And if you have any questions or anything, always feel free to ask me. Thank you guys for all your support and your kindness, and I'll see you in the next one.